The object tree in Beyond is a place where almost every parameter that exists in Beyond that can be modified is located. I say almost as there are a few things that are blocked here for safety reasons. The object tree can be found in many places in Beyond, but the easiest way to get there is under Tools, Object Tree. You can have a list of all objects below. As you select objects, the fields above will fill out. The first is your Beyond identifier. This is the code to reference to that specific object. If you want to reference to that object in use in PangoScript or the Object Animator, for instance. Below that is the OSC address, so if you want to reference that object over OSC, you can use that address. On the bottom, you can also get information about what the object is here, and more info about an object here. To navigate the object tree, you double-click on the parent object for any in the list. This may or may not lead to more drop-downs for parameters. A good first example is the Video Output 1 object. Let's double-click on it. Here we'll give you the parameters that exist for that object. In our case, it is the width and height in pixels, top and left positions in pixels on the monitor, and if the window is visible. You can highlight any of these to update the identifier and OSC address above. Once you find what you are looking for, you can copy the identifier for use elsewhere. Some objects have very deep trees, so in that case, we will look at a universe layout page. Here I have a page called Preview Demo. In here we have many zones and projector sources. If we go back to the object tree, then we can double-click on this universe layout. This will lay out all the objects that exist within that tab. However, all of these have objects beneath them, like a projector. You will also see at the end something that says Array of 18 items. This is used to identify all objects that may exist in a parent. You can double-click on it, and it'll ask you to pick the index number of the object. So if we type 0, this will be the first projector from above. This might not seem too useful here where all the previous objects are already displayed. However, in other places, the array is the only option. In our last example, we will look at the last parent object, the zone. Here we can have just an array of items. This corresponds to the zones in order of our zone settings. We can type 0 for the first zone. Here we can enter that first zone and see all the objects that exist within that zone, which in case of a zone, many objects or parameters, values, and more. The object tree, while it's on its own, doesn't let you create anything. It is a tool to help you find the right parameters of Beyond you need for your scripts, code, and animations to help with automations, modifications, and really just getting Beyond to do whatever you want it to do. Because even if a feature may not exist, it is possible that you could use PangoScript and the object tree to create that feature yourself. Thanks for watching this Quick Hints video on the object tree. We encourage you to take a look at the Object Animator Quick Hints video for more information about this area of Beyond. If you still need help, feel free to contact support@pangolin.com and we'll help you as soon as possible.